Hi and hello dear friends, welcome back once again to our channel Vagai Academy of Mathematics, and this playlist is where you can find video lessons for CAT, MAT and other management exams. This session we have a very basic problem from the concept of permutation and combination. Let us see the question. So our question here is, in how many ways the letters of the word polis, okay, the word is given word is polis, okay, polis, can be rearranged such that the vowels are always together. Okay, so this is going to be the question. I hope the meaning is very clear to you, and you must have seen questions like this very frequently. Yes, okay, this is going to be a very famous, very popular kind of question, like these kind of questions. So given a word, here our word given is polis. Okay, let us note it, p-o-l-i-c-e. So if you see here, this is going to be a six letter word, right? So there are six letters here, and also another advantage is all the letters are distinct. There's no repetition in the letters. Okay, no repetition is here. And and what is the condition? The question is, in how many ways we can rearrange these letters in such a way that, okay, such that, the condition is very important here, such that the vowels are always together. Okay, so you see some vowel letters here in this word, and the vowels should be always together. In such a way we have to arrange these letters. So that can be done in how many possible ways? This is going to be this question, and we also have the options, so we have to work out and then get the answer. This is going to be, as I told, this is going to be a very basic question. Okay, so yes, let us see an approach how we can solve this question. So first of all, we'll try to understand the question very carefully. Okay, so given the vowels are always together, okay, so let us try to pick the vowel letters from this word. Okay, so what are the vowel letters? We know vowels are A, E, I, O, U, correct? So here, pick the vowels here. So here O is a vowel, correct? And then I is a vowel, and then E is a vowel. So there are three letters. So totally six letters are here. Among them, three of them are vowels. Okay, so that means the way we are going to arrange these letters, how it should be? It should be in such a way that the vowel letters should be always together. That is, this O, I, E, okay, O, I, E, all these letters should be always together. That means they should not be separated by a consonant. Okay, what do you mean by consonant? The letters other than vowels are consonant. Okay, so in that way, if you see how many vowels are here, there are three vowels, and how many consonants are here? There are three consonants. Okay, so what are the consonants here? P, L and C. Those three letters are going to be consonant letters, is it or not? So that means I should not have any consonants in between these vowels. That is the meaning. Okay, in that way we have to arrange. Okay, so that means our arrangement can be in what possible ways? We can have it as O, I, E, P, L, C. We can have it like this. This is one possible way, right? Okay, see here, all the three vowels are together only, is it or not? We can even have it like this, P, O, I, E, then L, C. Okay, see here, though they are coming in between, they are not separated, is it or not? All three letters are coming together. Okay, no matter where they are positioned, but they all should come together. This is the meaning. Okay, but we should not have an arrangement like P, L, then O, then we have a C, then I, then E. This should not happen. Okay, why? Because you see here there are two vowels, O and I, are separated by another consonant. Okay, so this should not happen. This is the way they are asking us to arrange this given word polis. Okay, so that means what we can do here, that is what we have to think. Okay, and another important thing here we have to notice, it is only given that the vowels should be coming together, and they can come in any order they want, is it or not? Can understand that meaning? Yes, see here, we had O, I, E like this. Okay, it can even be P, then we can even have I, O, E, then C, L coming. That order can vary. Okay, but see here, all the three vowels are together only, so they should be together, but within themselves they can be in any possible order. Okay, all these conditions we have to keep in our mind, and then accordingly we have to work this problem. Okay, because understanding this question itself will be very, very important. Okay, it's considered to be very important. Okay, those who are preparing advanced questions, they may feel these conditions to be very basic. They can easily understand this. Okay, the moment they see the question, they can easily understand it. But for those who are preparing from the very basic, okay, so they'll not be much aware of these conditions and everything. So it is better to revise and see, and that's the reason I'm just explaining these things. Okay, so I hope now you are clear with in what possible ways we should arrange, in what possible ways we should not arrange. Okay, so this is what I've just given some examples. Okay, now I think we can get into the solving part. Okay, all right, yes. Now come here, we have got three vowels here, correct? Yes. And condition says all three vowels should be coming together. That is what this question says. Is it or not? So in that case, what we will do is we will just take the vowels O, I, E and we will just make them as one bunch. We will consider them to be one bunch or one package. That is, wherever I take this, all three letters will come together only. I hope you can understand this. So now these three letters I made it as one bunch. So it is like there is only one letter now. Okay, as of now, let us consider like that. Okay, there's only one bunch, one letter is there like that. Okay, all three are together like one single object. Okay, we'll have it like this. And what are the other letters? Other letters are P is there, L is there, C is there. These are three distinct letters. Fine, okay, because there's no condition between, or there's no condition which is posted on this consonants. Okay, that means we will consider these letters to be individual letters. Okay, fine, yes. So that means if I view overall, what happens is our task is to arrange how many objects are here now. There are only four objects here, is it or not? One, see, for us this is going to be one single object. Okay, one and two, three, four. That means there are four objects. So our task is to just arrange these four objects. Now you consider, if you arrange these four objects, they can come in whatever order they want, is it or not? And remember, now you take this as a single bunch, right? So wherever you take this, you take this as a bunch. Okay, so that you cannot separate this vowels, they all will be coming together. I hope now you got the point, right? So this is what we are just doing. This adjustment is what we are doing in order to take the vowels together. Okay, to arrange the vowels together. I hope you got this point now. When you make it as a single bunch, this will become one single object, and hence all the vowels will be always together. Okay, fine, yes. Now tell, there are four objects now and all the four objects are distinct objects, is it or not? So how many ways to rearrange these four objects? 1, 2, 3, 4. So there are four objects here, so these four objects can be rearranged in 4 factorial ways, is it or not? Because 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 it comes. So we have 4 factorial ways in which we can arrange these four objects. That is over, and our problem is not yet over. We have to continue. We have something more to do here. Just multiply it by. We have got one more task here. What is it? We have arranged these four objects. That is okay, fine, but we have one single object here, right? This OIE, that is acting as a one single object. Now carefully listen here, what we are going to do is, here these three objects are coming together, that is okay, well and accepted, but they can be arranged within themselves in any possible order, correct? Is it or not? They can be arranged within themselves. So that means our task is to arrange these three objects within themselves. Now tell me, to arrange these three objects within themselves, how many ways are there? Three objects are there, is it or not? So that means I can arrange them in 3 factorial ways. So overall, what will be our answer? 4 factorial into 3 factorial. Be clear with each and every expression we write here. Okay, fine, yes. See, this first 4 factorial stands for these four objects. 1, 2, 3, 4. This bunch, one object, and one P, one L, and one C. So we arrange these four objects, for which is what we are writing this 4 factorial, which is multiplied by this 3 factorial. This one stands for we arrange the vowels within themselves. Fine, yes, okay, because they can be in any order within themselves. It can be like OIE or OEI or EIO, in whatever order they want. Within themselves, they can be arranged in 3 factorial ways. That is what this one stands for. Okay, so that means for each of these 4 factorial ways, we have got these single, for each of those possibilities, we have got 1, 1, 3 factorial ways. That is the reason we multiply. And so our final answer becomes 4 factorial into 3 factorial. Now we have to simplify this. So 4 factorial will be nothing but 24, because 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 is 24. And 3 factorial will be like 3 twos, and 1s, right? 3 into 2 into 1, which will be 6. So that means we'll have our answer to be 24 into 6, which will become 4, 2 and then 14. So 144 is going to be our final answer for this question. Okay, I hope you are able to understand it clearly. So it's a very basic question. Okay, I hope again I'm telling those who are preparing advanced questions might feel this question to be very, very easy. Okay, they would have crossed this question very long ago, but for beginners this is going to be a very important model. I think starting from here is going to be fine for you to understand this permutation combination ideas. Okay, fine. Yes, so that's the reason we are starting from some kind of basic question. So yeah, answer is going to be 144 for this question, and we are having our answer at option C. Okay, option C, 144 is going to be the answer for this question. Yes, okay, fine.